Hi and welcome back to another video. In this video, we're going to set up our Contabo server. We're going to create the account. If you want to get to this page on Contabo, just go to bizanosa.com/contabo and the link is in the description. I will choose this option. You can choose any option that you want. You can even choose any of these other servers. You can use any of this dedicated server or virtual dedicated server, whichever one you want to use, go ahead and try it. Now for me, I want to try it with this, and this is the one that I'm going to use. I will just click there on select. These are the settings you're going to get. Now, initial contact period, there you can choose whichever you want. The region, just note that with the region, the monthly price is going to vary. So the monthly charge for your server is going to vary based on the location of the server. If I choose a data center in the United States, you can see the price, the monthly price is going to increase by that. If I choose one in Asia, the price is going to increase by $3. So just choose one that is most appropriate for you and your visitors. We have chosen this region of Germany. The next option is we need to choose an operating system. Okay, look at all the operating systems that are available here, and you can choose whichever one you want to use. For me, I want to use Ubuntu, but the best option for Ubuntu, if you don't want to use Ubuntu, you can always use Debian. If this was my server, I would definitely be using Debian, but I'm just using Ubuntu because I know most people prefer to use it, and that's why I want to use it here. You can see the Linux server operating systems that I recommend. The link will be in the description. Now, I will start with Ubuntu 24 and always use an LTS version. If your VPS doesn't have 2004, then just use the latest, the previous one, which is 1804. But of course, you should probably use the latest LTS version of Ubuntu. And so we're going to use 2004, which is the latest LTS version. And then this, we're going to leave that as it is. IP, you can add another IP. If you want to add an additional IP, it will be $4 a month. So your monthly charges will also increase by that based on the IP addresses that you add. So we're going to choose only one IP address. And then backup space, if you want to add backup, you can do that and the prices are there. If you want your server to be managed by Contabo, you can see that's the monthly price. You can monitor your server and see how it's performing. If anything is happening that you don't want, any resources are being overused, you will get alerts for that. And you can use SSL if you want to add SSL, but please don't bother with this because you're going to install a control panel, and with most control panel nowadays you'll get Let's Encrypt, which is already set up in most control panels. So don't worry about SSL, you can set that up using the free control panel that you're going to install. And then setup, if you want to fast track the setup, you can choose this. This is going to make sure that your account is set up faster, but who cares, right? We are patient, we'll wait. And then how many servers do you want to set up? If you want multiple servers, you can choose the number of servers that you want to set up. Maybe you want to set up multiple, you can do that there. So that's pretty much it. Let me just confirm that everything is as I chose it. So Ubuntu, there, I'll just go next. So you can see I will need to log in. So I already have an account with Contabo. If you don't have an account, just go ahead and create yours. And if they ask you for any details to verify your identity, just send them something. You can send them anything that has your actual physical address on it, like a billing, any form of billing that you have, water bill or an electric bill. You can send that. You can just scan it and send it. And it will be used to verify your identity. Private, individual, let's forget about that. I want to log in. I'm already a customer. So if you want to log in future, if you want to log into Contabo, you can just go to my.contabo.com. So let's come in here and do my.contabo.com. Enter. And that's going to redirect you to the login page for Contabo. So when you're here, you can just click here. Log in here if you're already a customer. I don't remember my password. I'm going to reset mine here. So just log in and we'll meet in the next screen. Log in here. Let's see. So once I reset my password, let me come back and log in here. Okay, so I'm logged in. If you have a coupon code, just click there and add one. That's it. You'll see the amount you should pay. and I will just order and pay. I will just wait for this, for them to finish provisioning the server. And as soon as it's provisioned, what's going to happen is you're going to get all the details that you need to log into your server. You're going to receive them in your email. Everything that you need will be sent to your email. And before this happens, let's say your account is new, what they will need or what they may need is some kind of document just to prove yourself, okay? So as I said, if they ask you for anything to prove your physical address, just send any kind of billing. You can send an electric bill, water bill, any kind of bill that has your physical address on it, and they will use that to verify you. And as soon as you're verified, they will create your account and they will create your server, and all the details will be sent to you. If you don't want to deal with all this verification stuff, just choose a VPS in America. You can choose something like Valtra. That's one that I use a lot and I can definitely recommend them. They have very fast servers, even though their offers are not as good as Contabo. So let's just wait and see if it's going to get provisioned for me as soon as possible. As soon as you log into your Contabo account, once they have sent you all the details, you'll see your servers here. Any VPSs that you have, any services that you have with Contabo, you can just click there and you'll see the details for all the servers listed. And you can also look at the VPSs that you have right there. They will be listed here. If you did choose VDS, then you can look at that as well. Right now, there isn't much I can do. Therefore, I'm just going to wait for an email from Contabo, and once it comes, we can begin setting up the server in the next video. So what I'm waiting for is an IP address, a root user, and a password. So once all that is set up for me, I can start setting up my server. And as I said, we're going to use this post to set up our server, okay? So the link for this will be in the description. If it's not there, just remind me and I will add it, or you can just go to Google or Bing and search for Bizanosa Ubuntu server setup and you're going to find this post, okay? So for me, I'm going to use Git Bash to set up my server instead of using Party, okay? You can see this is Party. I'm not going to use Party. I'm going to use Git Bash. So you can just use Terminal if you're on Mac, and you can use Terminal as well if you are on Linux. So I will see you in the next video when we start setting up the server. I'm just waiting for the details from Contabo. All the details I need will be sent to my email as soon as the server is set up for me. So if you don't want to deal with all this waiting process from Contabo, you can use a different VPS, and American VPSs usually don't have this wait period. An example is DigitalOcean, Valtra. I've used both and you can use them if you want to. If you want to set up a server just to try something, go ahead and use Valtra or DigitalOcean. But I do recommend Valtra because I used them for over 4 years and I still use them to this day. So I can definitely vouch for Valtra. Very reliable, very fast servers as well. It's entirely up to you to use whichever you want, but you can also see the VPSs that I recommend. So I've just received all the login data for my Contabo server. So what I got are the IP address, server type, the VNC IP and port. So VNC can be used to access your server remotely, and then the VNC password as well. And then you're going to get the username, and the username by default is root, and you're going to get a password for the root user and the type of operating system that you set up. You're going to get all of this in your Contabo first email. So if your account is new, you're also going to get your Contabo login details, and you can use that to log into your Contabo dashboard. We want to log into our server, and now that we have all the details, we can do that. We are interested in VPS control because we did set up a VPS. If you don't know which IP address you're working with or which is which, just go to your email address and look at the IP address that has been sent there. So you'll see the operating system, and if you're not sure, you can also come here under services. All right, so if you want to log into your server, the first thing you want to do is make sure that you restart your server. So the server will be restarted, and as soon as you do that, give it some time and just copy this, our IP address. We have the IP address, we have the user, our user is root, and we have the password that was sent for root. And you can find that in your Contabo email. To log in, so on Windows, I'm going to use Git Bash. You can download Git Bash for free and install it. If you are on a Mac or Linux, you can use Terminal to follow along. So just search for Git, if you're on Windows, that is, search for Git, download, and then click on that. You want to download it for Windows. Since you're on Windows, you're probably following along on Windows. Choose Windows and install it. And once you install it, it's going to come with everything we need. And we're going to use Git Bash for this tutorial. Once you install it, just come back to Windows and then search for Git. We want to work with Git Bash. You can see there's Git GUI and there's Git CMD, but I only want to use Git Bash. To log in, type SSH and the user is root at the IP address. So with this, I think you can paste. Let's see how you can paste. That is at root at, and then you can paste and you can do shift insert to paste. And as soon as I do that, it's going to ask me for the password. And you can see it's asking me to authorize this into my host's file. I'm going to type yes to affirm that. And it will be added to my host's file. So it will be a known host on my computer and I can access it without any problems. We need to add the password. So you can paste it in here by doing shift insert. If you just do that, you can paste using shift insert, yes. And you won't see the password as you type it in or as you paste it in. So just press enter. And if it is correct, you should be logged into your server. There we go. That's how to log into your Contabo server. Of course, the first thing you want to do is you want to update your server. So since we are still using root, I can just do apt update enter. Let's see if there are any updates. All right, so you can see 4 packages can be upgraded. So let's do apt upgrade to upgrade, enter, then y, enter. So just let it update and that will be pretty much it. So you've seen how you can set up your Ubuntu server on Contabo and then log into your Ubuntu server VPS. If you want to start setting it up. So just remember that we are going to start using this post to set up our server. So there we go. Our updates are done. If you want to log out of your server, you can just do exit. And that's going to log you out of your server. Okay. So let's continue in the next video. And in the next video, what I want us to do is I want us to come in here and we are going to create a new sudo user. The link to this post is in the description. There we go. We're going to do this in the next video.